Hello friends, welcome to this episode of Science for Common Man. It's interesting to note that the moon always shows the same face to Earth, and from Earth we never get a chance to see the faraway side of the moon. This happens because while orbiting Earth, moon spins on its own axis also, and it completes exactly one rotation on its own axis by the time it completes one revolution around Earth. Thus, always one side is facing the Earth. And you know, our moon is not the odd one out there. Same is the case with the moons of Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, etc. Is it just a coincidence or is there any physics behind it? Let's find it, and I promise to keep it simple and comprehensive. Moon or any space object is actually made of pieces of masses held in place by the binding forces caused by its own gravity. Now, our moon, such a chunk of masses, is revolving around Earth. What is Earth doing to it? Earth, being a giant mass compared to Moon, is exerting a force of attraction on Moon. Generally, we assume this force to be acting at a single point or at the center of Moon. But in fact, it is acting on all of these masses independently and directed towards the center of Earth. And again, this force of attraction by Earth, in fact, reduces with distance from Earth. So, the parts which are closer to Earth experience the highest force, and farthest parts have lowest force. So we have a nominal force in the center, highest here and lowest here. Now, what is the effect of these varying forces? To find it, let's offset these forces by the nominal force in the center so that we will get the force distribution relative to the center, and it is like this. These stretching forces on these locations produce a minor shape change or bulges in the moon, and at these locations they produce contractions. These varying forces are called tidal forces, and the bulges produced by them are called tidal bulges. These bulges are aligned to the line connecting to center of Earth. Now, what happens if the moon is not at all spinning on its own axis? Remember, the bulges have to be aligned to the center line. So, when moon travels from A to B, the bulge should travel through the surface of moon as we see here from location of blue dot to red dot. That is, bulging and contracting locations in moon's surface should keep on varying like a wave traveling through the surface of moon. The material of moon exerts resistance to this periodic reshaping of its surface. Due to this resistance, some time is required now for formation of bulge in an area. That means, the bulges lag behind the center line like this. Now, because there are bulges on two sides, additional gravitational force from Earth would act on these bulges like this, and a force acting away from center would produce a rotating effect on any body, and these two forces tend to rotate the moon. This force in this sense and this in opposite sense. And since this bulge is closer to Earth, this force would be more, and the net rotational tendency or so-called torque would be in this direction. This rotational effect tends to rotate the moon to align the bulge along the center line, and continuous action of this over a period of time, maybe thousands of years, would provide a spinning to moon. Gradually, the bulges stop traveling over the surface of moon and settle to a permanent location, and moon continuously spins to align this location to the center line. This is called tidal locking. As a result of this, the time periods of spinning of moon and revolution of moon around Earth become equal, and both are 27.3 days. Now, what if moon starts spinning at a faster rate than this? The bulges would be lagging like this, and this would cause a net torque like this, and this would continuously reduce the spinning rate of moon till it gets tidally locked again. If by any effect the rate of rotation of moon becomes higher or lower than this, this torque will appear again, and over a period of time it will get locked again. Now, actually the force between moon and Earth is mutual, or in other words, moon is also exerting a force on Earth which also varies with distance, and this should produce bulges and rotating effect on Earth and try to reduce the rate of spinning of Earth. Believe me, it's there. But because Earth is so massive compared to Moon, the rate at which the spinning is reduced is so less. In fact, every year, the duration of day is lengthened by 15 microseconds due to this. At this rate, it will take long time for the Earth and Moon to get mutually locked to each other, and before this can happen, our Sun would become a red giant and will engulf both Moon and Earth. Till then, let's keep on finding reasons for the interesting observations around us. Subscribe and be with us in this journey. Signing off, Science for Common Man.